Beer, maybe, or maybe some good coffee and stuff like that, you know.
Yeah, it's always a horror to find coffee the next morning because you can be a little bit hungover and stuff like this. So.
Yeah.
And I think you got lots of great stuff here in like Germany and Austria, but I think your weak spot is the coffee, actually. Yeah.
Doing the same thing maybe but in a different way, you know, and today is everybody's fighting on the little piece of bread, you know, and for the gold corn, what the hell, but I think that's not the much difference, maybe, I don't know.
I think people nowadays are like not very much into this like longer songs which are hard to get for like more concept album stuff and things like this. So they want this like 2 minute pop song, and if a band writes a really great pop song, they're like birdmarked with that pop song and the rest is shit to most of the audience. But yeah, that's just like, I don't know.
This band with another drummer called Jan-Olofer Karlsson, and they're playing this.
Hansson and Karlsson, they were called.
Yeah.
Well, Hansson should be on the new Mummy since we
yeah.
But they're all like on this new wave now of like more or less clones of Hansson and Karlsson, like drums and the organ.
Okay.
There are like several good bands right now that play this style.
Cool.
Well.
That's still continuing the. That band, so
I think like the whole Syd Barrett records or label will like because he captures the spirit of like all the, his issues in his like soul material, which I find really like heartbreaking for me.
Okay.
I went to this King Diamond show and I just stand there crying all the time.
Okay.
It was too good to be true. Couldn't bear it alone, so I had to just release it.
I'm playing Eski Classic, I think it's called. Now I play a Fender amp and have a little 4/10 cab
okay.
To it, so it's very easy to carry.
Okay.
Is that dual showman, right?
Yeah, yeah. It's almost a twin reverb in
okay, cool.
Head format.
Yeah, I play a Marshall VBA 400 tube amp with an amp bag 8/10, like an old, real battered one.
Okay.
That's yeah,
yeah.
It's pretty shitty for sounds. And I play on a Squier P bass from the 80s.
I use a Premier, old Premier drum set. It's champagne sparkling, so it really looks it's cool, cheesy, and interstationalized, you know. And to that I use some one K Crash, I think it's called, the dark crash symbol, and then a big beat, 24 inches, I think it is. And then some chopsticks to that. See you next time.